Hey guys, my name is Maurico Quiroga. My buddy Omar over at AV Educate asked me a while back to put together a quick class on Companion. I couldn't agree to that because I honestly am not capable of teaching people. I did, however, agree to put together this quick tutorial video. Now, today we're just going to touch on the basics of Companion. It's not going to be a very in-depth video. It's just going to be a quick tutorial on the very basics. It's mostly going to touch on IP settings, and we're probably going to go a little bit into the Blackmagic Atem, E2, QLab, and PlayBack Pro. I don't know much about lighting or audio when it comes to Companion, so I will definitely not touch base on that. Hopefully somebody else can cover that on a video later on. Let's go ahead and get started. We're going to go ahead and open up the IP settings on my Mac. I've already gone ahead and done some of these, but we're going to go into our USB and we're going to go ahead and set an IP manually. I've gone ahead and done 192.168.10.25. That is going to be in the same IP bound. That is going to be on the same IP block as my Atem and my PC later on when I touch into that side of things. We're going to go ahead and close this out and let's go ahead and open Companion. Once we go there, you go into the GUI interface and we're going to go to the same IP address that I just did and launch GUI. Now, I don't have an Atem here at home with me, so we're just going to assume there is one and touch on the basics for that. We would go into search, type in Atem, that'll come up right away, and now we would type in the IP address of the Atem, which would be 192.168.10.240. Go ahead and hit apply changes. And normally, when you go back to the instance window, status would say OK. That's not going to be the case here. We're going to go over to Surfaces, Rescan USB. And it's giving me a problem. All right. We're going to hit Rescan USB, and there we go. Now it finally shut up. I just had to unplug it and plug it back in, which is something that could happen on the field. We're going to go over to the buttons and preset window, Blackmagic Design, Preview. This would show all the same inputs that you've renamed on the Atem page. And you would normally just drag and drop those inputs 1 through 4, for instance, in this case, and that could be graphics 1, 2, playback A and B. A thing I like to do normally is go into the button themselves, add feedback, and I am going to change colors from program. Do input 1 for input 1. Go back, do the same thing over and over again. Input 2. Input 3, and so on. That would normally give you a tally light that corresponds with the Atem. It won't show up here because we do not have one connected, but if I hit 1 and took that to my preview, it would light green. If 2 was on my program, it would light red. We can go back and go to our preset window. And if I remember correctly on the Atem, there is no take function on the preset. So we normally have to do that ourselves. And we would go and hit auto transition operation. I do have a quick PNG image that I normally throw into this, go ahead and type Companion, got a folder for that. Companion presets, and there it is. That now shows down there. This would give us basic control of all of our instances for any time. If you have any macros to do a key or anything like that, it would definitely be under the preset window as well, under macros, and it would be renamed however you did on the Atem software. That is very basic for Companion with the Atem. The main thing you want to focus on is making sure your IP addresses are the same. Otherwise, you will definitely come into problems. All right, so now that we've done Companion on our Mac, we're gonna move over to our PC. Unfortunately, my screen recording is a little bit different on the PC, so I'm only going to be able to show you once I've done my IP settings. That would be under System Preferences, Network. You're going to do IP Level 4 and go into Setup, Change Adapter Options, and you would go to Properties, Version 4 TCP/IP, and there you would do a manual IP address. I am doing it slowly. I don't think it's going to record though, but now I'm back in Companion, and we're going to go ahead and do the same thing. We're going to add our Atem. Target IP will be the same as before, 192.168.10.240. Apply changes. Go over to the buttons, presets, preview, same thing. And then bottom right button, we would do a auto transition. Here I don't have a picture, so it's going to be text, and that would just be take. Normally I would make that text red. Alright, we're going to go back to instances, and we are going to now add QLab. Target IP will be 192.168.10.25 because that's the IP address of my Mac. We're going to go ahead and hit Apply Changes. OK lit up because my Mac is in the same network. We're going to go to Configure. Actually, we're going to go to Buttons. Go back to Presets. And now we can see the QLab button. So we're going to go ahead and do our Go button, our Panic button, Previous Queue, Next Queue. Now over on my Mac, I'm going to go ahead and open up QLab. And we're going to do a new workspace. We're going to drop in few videos I've already assigned. Select all of them and select our second surface as our display. Now theoretically I should be able to hit next queue, hit go, and it worked. This is my Stream Deck connected to my PC and it automatically triggered the video. I can go ahead and hit panic, hit up my next queue, hit go. Same thing, video worked immediately. I can hit panic again. My next queue's already lit up. Hit go. And so on. Now that is a very basic QLab. I'm really not gonna go more in depth because I'm still figuring out QLab myself. I don't fully know how to make the transitions work properly. But this will work as a quick and easy playback option. So now that we've covered the Atem and QLab, we're going to go ahead and do PlayBack Pro. For that, we're going to go over to our Mac again, and we're going to open up PlayBack Pro Plus. This will be just the demo version because unfortunately, my license is internet activated and is on my rental computers at the moment, which are not at my house. We're going to go ahead and dump the same four videos. And we're going to select TCP/IP listen. Once that's done, we'll go over to our PC. We will search for PlayBack Pro Plus. We're going to go ahead and add that. The IP address will be the same as earlier, 192.168.10.25, since that is my Mac. Apply changes. And once we go to instances, it'll be there and show us OK. We're going to go ahead and go to a new page, page 2, go to presets and DT Video Labs program. Take, kill, pause, previous, next. All of these are presets for this instance.
and it will give us full control of PlayBack Pro automatically. We'll be able to select the clip we want to play, hit take, and it will automatically take. One of the cool features about this is it gives us a quick and easy pause option, which will come in handy during rehearsals, as clients very often ask to pause videos on the fly. Hit pause again and it continues playing.
This is Ocean Way Studio.
Kill, and you're out of there. And that is the basic PlayBack Pro Plus. Now we're going to go ahead and close out of our PC and go back to our Mac companion. And here I'm going to talk a little bit about E2. For companion, which won't function fully since I'm not connected to an E2 again. We're going to go ahead and launch our GUI. So now that we're in our GUI, we're going to go ahead and search for Barco. We're going to go down to Event Master. We're going to do the IP within the same block, so 192.168.10.175. Apply changes, go over to buttons, and the same thing. This will show us a very small list of presets. We would add take. However, once you go into the buttons, you'd be able to add preset and preview, and this would give you normally a list of presets that you've already created in Event Master. You would be able to select the presets based on either the number or the name you've assigned to them within the Event Master software. I unfortunately am not able to do this at the moment because I do not have an E2 connected, but hopefully this helps show you guys a lot of the basics for an E2. I believe the same is the case for an Ascender, and I have not been able to play with an Aqualon, so I do not know how Companion functions with it. I know that with the Ascender, there's a couple of differences as far as taking screens. It doesn't do it based on the preset, but rather the selection of screen destinations you've picked in Companion for that current take. Unfortunately, without having a switcher in front of me and being able to network into them, I can only touch on the few things I am able to and recall from my time working with them. Hopefully this video has helped some of you. If you do have any questions, please do write them in the comment section in the Facebook page. I am not going to give out my email. I am not going to give out my number because I do not want to be answering any questions directly. Hopefully, within the thread of this video in the AV Educate Facebook page, we'll be able to answer any questions that anybody has, either myself or somebody else that knows Companion. And that's going to be it for me. Hopefully, you guys have enjoyed this. And I really hope it wasn't as much of a pain in the ass for you guys as it was for me. Thank you very much.